In this tutorial, we're going to show you how to obtain a refresh token for testing your code without having to write the code to handle the authorization flow yourself. The first thing you'll want to do is browse the OAuth Playground. The OAuth Playground is a tool hosted on Google Developer site that lets developers see authorization flow step by step and see how API calls are made at the HTTP layer. You can find the OAuth Playground at developers.google.com/OAuth Playground. Or by searching for OAuth Playground in your favorite search engine. For today's tutorial, we're only going to show the steps required to obtain a long-lived refresh token that we can exchange for access tokens to make YouTube Data API and YouTube Analytics API calls. The first thing we need to do is configure the OAuth Playground to use our client secret and client ID. Let's find our client ID and client secret from the Google API console. We're going to need these in a second. Browse back to the OAuth Playground and click the Settings button. Let's check the box using Use Your Own OAuth Credentials. And let's make sure the access type is set to offline, because this is what we need to ensure that we receive a long-lived refresh token and not a short-lived access token. We'll be presented with two fields, one for client ID and one for client secret. Let's copy-paste the values over from the API console. There's one more thing we need to set up. Note that we have a redirect URI setup that points to developers.google.com/OAuth Playground. This is important because the OAuth Playground requires us to redirect back to the Playground after an authorization step. Let's click on Edit Settings. If we haven't set this yet, let's enter this into the Authorize Redirect URIs box and click Update. Now let's go back to the OAuth 2 Playground. Let's select the APIs to authorize. Scrolling down, we're going to select the YouTube Analytics API, a read-only scope, and the YouTube Data API v3. Now let's click Authorize APIs. We'll be forwarded to a page where we'll need to grant access. If we're in charge of multiple channels, we'll first be presented with an account picker. Let's click Accept and Continue. We now have an authorization code, which we can use to exchange for a refresh token and access token. Let's click Exchange Authorization Code for Tokens. The OAuth 2 Playground will populate the refresh token and access token fields after making the API call. We can start using these immediately, but the value we want to save for our scripts is in the refresh token field. As we can see, the access token will expire in about 1 hour. The official Google API clients will all handle obtaining an access token for us as long as we supply a client ID, client secrets, and refresh token. And that's how we generate a refresh token using the OAuth Playground.